Greetings, and welcome to another episode of ETCG1. I am Eric the Car Guy. Hey, if you're looking for repair videos, head on over to my Eric the Car Guy channel. I'll post the link in the description to that. But here on ETCG1, we just talk about stuff. So if you want to stick around and join in the discussion, feel free to do so. If you're looking for repair videos, click that link in the description and go check those out. Today's topic, the most important investment on your vehicle. In my humble opinion, that is tires. Nothing is a better investment in how your vehicle rides, how your vehicle handles, how your vehicle brakes, how your vehicle does every single thing it has to do. Everything about your vehicle, be it a truck, be it a SUV, be it a Civic, a two-door spec, a G-Wiz, a Skoda, doesn't matter what it is. Everything that's out there touches the road predominantly in four spots. And those four spots of the road are your tires. They are the interface between you and the driving world. So everything all the terrain you drive over, all the miles you traverse, everything passes past those tires. A long time ago, my dad instilled this philosophy into me. And he told me the story about when he was a kid and my grandfather was driving back from someplace, and maybe driving a little too fast in a 1940s whatever, and hit a patch of water or wet road or something like that. Vehicle spun out, flipped over. My grandfather ended up hurting his shoulder, and it hurt him for the rest of his life. My dad was okay. My grandma was okay. Everybody was shook up, maybe a little bit beat up. But ultimately, what the issue was is that my grandfather did not invest in new tires on his vehicle, and as a result of that, his car lost traction, and that was, in essence, well, that and maybe a little bit of excessive speed is what caused the accident. Had he had new tires on that, that might not have been an issue. It might have just been a hiccup, a bump in the road, back away you go. However, it was not that. It was not what happened. So since I had started out, before I was a mechanic, before I was anything, teenager just learning how to drive, my dad had always instilled that in me. Now, later, when I became a technician, and was installing tires on different vehicles and actually many different types of tires sometimes on the same vehicle, this point we'll get to in a moment, the difference is like night and day. I'm sure the majority of you out there have gotten new tires at some point, and I'm sure after you've driven away from where you've gotten those tires, you are amazed at how different your car is. It's like a brand new car. It's amazing the difference that a new set of tires makes. Part of the reason for this is over time, as you use your tires, they warm up. And as they warm up and get cool, and warm up and get cool, and warm up and get cool, they eventually become the compound gets harder. And the harder the compound gets, the less traction you have. So when you first put on new tires, everything's nice and pliable and mushy and wonderful, and gives you all the traction, all the comfort, and many times a much quieter ride as a result. As those tires get older and they age and they get harder, they get noisier and noisier. And they also, once again, lose the ability to have the same kind of traction that they started out with. Now, I know some tire companies are out there that have made tires that actually the traction gets better the more they wear, because they have different rubber compounds, or I shouldn't really call them rubber. Not sure what I should call them. I just know that you put a good set of tires on something, it is the best investment. Now, I spent some money on these tires. In fact, I got about $600 in tires on this 2001 Odyssey. And some of you might question, you know, the philosophy behind that. But my answer to you is, number one, I'm a tire lover, and I buy the best tires that I can possibly buy whenever I'm faced with buying tires. And this being a minivan, something that my wife is going to drive predominantly with my kids in it, I want to give her every advantage that I possibly can. So I made that investment. I'm not faulting you for paying less for tires, any of that kind of stuff. I saved up. I literally saved up so that I could get these tires because that's what I wanted to have. Let's talk about tire types. This is the top of the line Michelin that you can get for this vehicle. I've worked on Hondas for more than 10 years now. And I can honestly say, particularly with Hondas, especially all the way through the 90s, up through the 2000s till now, they are very picky about the type of tires that you put on them. If you vary from what they put on that vehicle stock, you're asking for trouble. There is almost never an improvement over any other tire besides what came on that thing as original equipment. And that may be true for other brands as well. Now, I realize many of you are out there trying to save some money, but I'm asking you to question that philosophy. I'm asking you to say to yourself, okay, I need to buy some tires. You're in that position. Many of you are actually in a position where you're driving down the road, you lost the tire, you had a blowout, a slow leak, something like that. And now you're at the tire place and they're trying to sell you all four, at the very least two. And you really should buy tires in pairs. Because if you have one brand of tire on one wheel and on the opposite side of the axle, as it's called, even though it's not a real axle, even if it's in the rear and there's no axle there, they just use that as a point of reference on the same axis of the vehicle. So both tires in the rear, both tires in the front, it's really great if they're the same, because if they're mismatched, there's things that can happen. It can pull to one side, it sort of throws it out of whack. You need balance. Remember, you need balance with vehicles. And if you put different types of things on there, you're not gonna have a balance, it'll be out of balance. So you're trying to save some money, you just buy one tire, you're done. You're almost better off buying two cheap tires, you know, if you were looking for longevity. I can honestly say, especially with Hondas, get what came on the vehicle originally. Find out what came on it originally. And here's a resource for you. I didn't get paid to say this, nothing. I've been buying my tires from Tire Rack for years now, and they have a tremendous resource as far as you, people that have actually done reviews on the types of tires that they've gotten, the vehicle that they put them on, how many miles they have on there, how much they've driven them, that kind of thing. It really is a great resource, and I've actually been sending people to them for years just to read those peer reviews so that they can see, oh, well, this person bought this type of tire for that vehicle, was very unhappy, and it wasn't the only experience that was like that. There were three or four people that bought this particular brand of tire, put it on this particular vehicle that is just so happens to be my vehicle, all of them were unhappy. Flip side, you get a bunch of people saying, I can't say enough good things about these tires. They're the greatest things that I could have possibly put on there. Well, I can honestly say, I had one of those moments after I left my friend's garage where we put these tires on. Scott, you might remember him from the Element videos. It was, like I said, like night and day. I sort of had it going against me a little bit. I took a type of tire that belongs on an Acura Legend and I put them on these. They were roughly the same size. They were 16 inch. The tire size for this is 215, 65, 16 is what the original equipment tire size is for this. And you can often find that in the door jamb or in the glove box or in the owner's manual. I suggest you seek it out. I'm actually going to put a link in the description to the video I did about tires, which is similar to what I'm talking about here. But the difference between those MXV4 tires that I put on these and that I put on then and these that I put on now is that the MXV4s were 215, 60, 16. So there's just one number difference with the aspect ratio. I think that really came into play. I was never happy with those MXV4s. And for the money that I paid for them, I was really unhappy about that money. But now that I put these on, it's like I just got a new van. I'm serious. So instead of going out and getting myself a car loan, I saved up, bought a new set of tires. I feel like I got a new car. Something else I'm gonna throw in here for you technicians. Car comes in, it's got a new or newer set of tires on it. And it's in for like an oil change, maybe a tire rotation, something like that. Bring it in, changing the oil, you're rotating the tires and you notice, hey, the brakes on one side are really low in the front. And you take a look and you come to find out, hey, that caliper's bad. Well, then you're looking around some more, you're an industrious type, okay? You're not just going through the motions, doing what you're told, you're actually keeping an eyeball out and maybe finding other things that the customer might want to know about, like a bad caliper. You find that bad caliper, you go around back and then you decide to pull the drums off in the back, say it has drum brakes, and check the wheel cylinders. Well, you find two of the wheel cylinders to be leaking. You're like, oof, it just gets worse. And the whole time, the thing is sitting on the rack while you're doing the service, you're seeing like oil dripping on the floor, but it's not oil, it's transmission fluid. Maybe you see a little puddle of coolant starting over here. So you're starting to develop a list of issues that this vehicle has. Well, you write these things up, you put it on the work order, and either you talk to the customer directly or you hand it over to a service writer or somebody who does talk to customers directly, and you say, hey, I found these things while doing the service on this vehicle. You want to tell the customer about it. I will tell you, 8 times, maybe even 9 times out of 10, they're gonna do that work if they bought tires. Why? Because they've already made that investment. Like me, like I said, I'm in more than at least $600 into these tires. And it's changed everything about the vehicle for me. Customers are the same way. If that car comes in and it needs tires in addition to all that work, I would bet good money that thing gets buttoned up and shipped out the door, probably ends up being traded in or on a used car lot somewhere, just because they won't want to deal with it. But if it's got new tires on it, you might just find it's an easy sell. More information can be found about tires on that video in the description. But I just wanted to talk about that investment and give you my experiences and my stories with this. I look forward to your experiences. Please share them in the comments. And also there will be a link to a discussion about this video over at my forum. I'd love to see you over there. What is your opinion of the most important investment on your vehicle? I say it's tires. What do you say? Maybe you have a different take on the whole thing. Love to hear about it. That's what this is. This is a dialogue. Even though I'm making the videos, you and me, we're okay. Hey, if you have automotive questions, I would ask that you head over to airatthecarguy.com, where you will find right there on the homepage a list of categories of the most commonly asked questions that I've gotten over the past few years, that I've written article upon article upon article about, categorized, sliced it up, diced it up like a sushi chef, to the point where you can find information instantaneously. If you can't get an answer there, hey, there are other options. Type in a couple of keywords into that there search function at the top of the page, including any check engine light code you might have. That'll comb through our database and possibly come up with an answer to that query right then and there. And when I say keywords, I mean like brake pulsation. I mean like engine overheat. I mean stuff like that, not like, you know, a whole paragraph of the stuff. That ain't gonna work out for you. Keywords, just like Google, okay? If all that doesn't work for you, hey, feel free to sign up for our forum. It is absolutely free. All you need is an email address. Just be sure to respond to the confirmation email. It should show up in your inbox. If you do not find that, check your spam folder, bulk folder, that kind of thing, because you will need to click that activation link in order to become a member of airatthecarguy.com and post your question over at service and repair on our forum. You can also connect with me socially on Google+, Facebook, and Twitter, and I close my videos with be safe, have fun, and of course, stay dirty.